Hey guys, it's Tyler, and today we're going to be taking a look at an intermediate quantitative comparison question. So go ahead and pause the video and give yourself a few minutes to try this one on your own. All right, welcome back. Let's go ahead and talk about the solution to this one. First thing to note is that this is a quantitative comparison question. So do note that your goal is to ultimately compare quantity A to quantity B, and your four answer choices down here are going to be the same for every quantitative comparison question. So just starting to dissect this one, I know it's a coordinate geometry question, right? So I've got an X and a Y axis there. So one thing to note is that when it comes to coordinate geometry, this is always drawn to scale. So compared to some other geometry questions where the diagrams might be a little bit deceiving, it is safe to kind of trust your eyes on these types of questions. In terms of the quantities for A down here, I've got this kind of intimidating shape, parallelogram KLMN. And then for quantity B, I've got this quadrilateral JKLM. So looking at those shapes themselves, it is like a little bit intimidating. I might not know how to calculate the area of a, you know, kind of funny looking quadrilateral. But what we have to realize is that the people that write these questions are really masters of kind of obfuscating a simple question. So rather than thinking of these as a parallelogram and a quadrilateral, recognize that this bottom chunk down here, what we've got going on in the bottom chunk of the shapes, that's common between both my shapes. So if I'm trying to find and compare like the areas of the two, I don't really need to consider what's going on with this bottom chunk, because that's going to be the same in both my area calculations. So I'm just going to go ahead and ignore that bottom chunk. And instead, I'm going to kind of rephrase my goal here. So instead of thinking about parallelogram KLMN, all I really need to concern myself with is the triangle above the x-axis. So that's triangle MNK. Likewise, for quantity B, instead of thinking about the entire quadrilateral JKLM, I'm just going to think about that green triangle up there, triangle JKM. From here, I got to use my geometry rules. So if I'm trying to find the area of a triangle, that's going to be 1/2 base times height for MNK. And I'm also comparing that to 1/2 base times height for triangle JKM. Their bases, if you notice, I'm going from -4 to 4, right? The base is both going to be MK for both those triangles. So that's going to be 1/2 -4 to 4. That's a distance of 8. So 1/2 8 times whatever that height is. And then same thing for JKM, it's going to be 1/2 8 times whatever that height is. So now the question kind of is, what are the heights? Well, to calculate a height, remember that there's two things that are going to be true for any height. One is that a height is always perpendicular to the baseline. And second, it connects to the opposite vertex. So looking at these shapes here, for triangle MNK, my height, if I draw a line perpendicular to that baseline, to the opposite vertex, that's my height right there. So I'm going from 0 to 5, that is a height of 5. For triangle JKM, it's a little more complex here, but notice it has to be perpendicular to the baseline. So in some triangles, that actually means your height is gonna lie outside of the triangle itself. So if I try and draw a line perpendicular to that base MK, it's actually gonna fall just outside of the triangle a bit. But as you can see, I'm still going from 0 up to 5, so that's also a height of 5. And at this point, you can see 1/2 8 5, 1/2 8 5, those two calculations are gonna be equal. So my two quantities are equal and my answer is gonna be C. Subscribe for more GRE Math Spotlight videos from Manhattan Prep, and leave us a comment telling us how you solve this problem. Happy studying.